Hello everyone, today we'll be learning how to install using the offline downloaders files that we have right now. So for me, what I'm trying to do is restore my NFS heat. I have the files downloaded right now. I have over here. So these are the files that I backed up before I reset my system or I copied from someone else. So what you need to do is right now click on download and then just wait for and some pop-ups. Click on accept. Yes, just remember this path somewhere so that you don't have to do it again and again. So just remember this path, copy it somewhere and then click on next. Yes, default. The path could be different for various people, but for me it is this path. It for you it could be some other path based on where you installed the origin client. So now click on next. Once it's done, it will start downloading. Just click on pause and pause the download. Now, since we just wanted to have a folder setup and NFS heat to correspond to a special location, so what we'll do is we'll just copy the contents. And I remember the path over here was origin games and then NFS heat. So yeah, we have this folder over here. So what I'll do is I'll just copy paste all the contents of the previous folder that we had. So I have a great copy speed thanks to an NVMe. And okay, so not much thanks, but yeah, they are good. And NVMe's are good. They are very very fast. The copy speeds are amazing, and the transfer rates are also amazing. We've already been cached, so this is quite fast for us. So yes, we'll wait for a couple of minutes before we are done copying the contents of the folder, and then we'll just go ahead and resume our download. So this will help you because now you don't need to download from the internet. If you have already downloaded it, you don't need. If you have already the files, you file have restored it from somewhere, or you have kept a backup, or maybe you reset the system and then you had all those files available, but Origin does not allow restoring. So this is the only way that how we can restore our games. And if you have copied a file, a downloaded folder from someone, or someone has provided you already, so you don't want to go ahead and use your internet to download that, maybe because of your bandwidth limit or anything, or maybe you're not logged in, you want it to be done at the back end while you were working there somewhere else. So yeah, just go ahead and click on replace the files in the destination and done. Voila. So now what we'll do is we'll just go and click on resume button. This is a very small button that you can see over here, or even you can click on resume download here. Anyways would work. So I'll just click on resume, and then now you can see that it is resuming. It is verifying the files that we copied. It is not downloading from internet, and you can see that for me it is the internet is using only 144 kbps. And the download rate which you see is quite high. That means it is being restored, it is verifying the files over the internet and the local ones, whether the files are corrupted or not. If any of the files is corrupted or missing, it will automatically download that file. If in case you missed to copy some files, or there were some missing files, or files got corrupted while copying, it will download those, verify them, and once it is done, we are good to go. So you need not worry to download all the 34 GB. You just need to copy it. You can copy it any time of the day. You don't need to be signed in to download the game. All you need to do is a copy of the downloaded folder. Anyone can provide you if you've already done. This is a quite good thing. It helps us restore. We don't have something like in Steam. It does. We have backup and restore where we create DVDs for the game, so that anytime you want to restore the game, you can go ahead and restore it. In Origin, this is the only way how we can restore the games. Little different, but quite helpful at the same time. So now this will be downloading some prerequisites. I think so. It's installing some prerequisites at the same time. Once it is done, we'll be good to go. This will take some time to install the prerequisite, but yeah, depending on the system and what all prerequisites have been installed previously or not, it will verify those. And right now it is not downloading anything, it is just verifying those files over the internet. And I think so it, once it is done, we are good to go. Yes, I think so. We are on finalizing step, and I see the play button. So that means there is no more download that needs to be done. All my files were right for perfectly fine, and now we are good to go. We are ready to play the game. So how to play the game? You just need to go here, click on the game, and click on play button, and we are ready to play the game. Thanks. Thanks everyone for having me. Bye bye.